Who's the Instagrammable cat now? Who's the Instagrammable cat now? Yeah, the cat cleaned somewhat up. Claws. And. Yeah, okay. Never put him in those clothes. So, but he seems to enjoy it, I guess. This is his purring, so. Always take this as a. That's a good sign, I would say. Yeah, we're totally declining into cat content. But yeah, it's probably more popular than what I was doing before. Actually, I got a call from my boss yesterday evening, late evening, and they want us back in the home office. So they want us to go back to work. So yeah. So, since we have this cold going on, we stretch it for another week, but this will be probably the last week at home. And yeah, not too happy about it. But yeah, we didn't use the time well. So, let's see how that turns out. So, we cleaned the cat, and yeah, he is. Actually, I've gone. Oh, I have to go that Ian once more. Looks quite good. Yeah, but on the camera, it actually doesn't make as much difference. See, from. I was just editing the footage from last week. See. Yeah. Quite a clean cat now. And it's his birthday, actually. So, 1 year from James Purrington the First. So. They sell this as a police cap, as well as that one there. So, yeah. Wasn't there a police guy in the village people? Not quite sure. And why they're selling stuff for carnival in summer. That was really unsure what he wanted, but yeah, he only wanted his nest moved to the sun. So previously I have it here, and since the sun is turning around the corner there, we needed to move the nest there. Quite strange. So I just brought the auto back, the car back to the shop because yeah, they forgot to remove the horrible noise from the wheel bearings. So. Like we have in Germany, we have all 2 years mandatory inspection, which we call TÜV. And yeah, that's yeah, if you like every car in Germany, it has a small plaque there on his license plate, and you can see from the color and direction it's facing when its TÜV is going to expire, and yeah. You have to pay a hefty fine if you don't have the same. Yeah, like road safety inspection. And so it's one of the reasons you have not so many very old cars in Germany on the streets. The real junkers. There are two reasons. One is that this inspection. So, like for example, in our car, that costs about €1,000. That's also some bearings and stuff has had to be replaced. Which
would not be a terrible problem now, but they're quite strict there, so it was about 1000 euros for that. And the other thing, like the wheel bearings, after I drove on the cobblestones here, probably didn't hear that pass through, but it has to be done anyways. And yeah, it's a bit disappointing because, of course, it would have been a bit cheaper if they had done this with white array with all the other stuff, but yeah, they gave me a bit of discount. Probably had, would have, yeah. I'm still in the range which what I wanted to pay at maximum, so it's okay. And honestly, it's just something which is quite appeared. It's how expensive work hours is. Like, they want 95 euros per work hour on the car, so it's quite fast that you exceed the value of the car. But the really cheap cars you don't get at all in Germany, because you need a TÜV. That can be quite expensive on an old car. And if you buy a car from a vendor, he has to give you a mandatory guarantee. So, like, I think half a year or something. So if anything breaks on that junker car you bought for 250 euros from the back alley vendor, you can go there and he has to repair it. So they're not making any money. So like all cars which aren't that range, like our car, you can sell them, but they go straight to Russia, Africa, wherever they're allowed to run over. The work hours are so cheap that it's viable to repair them. So yeah, especially that guarantee thing is what has brought many old cars from our streets. And I think generally for safety it's not that bad. It's just if you are a young family or something, and you're probably paying a little bit more, because you cannot really get a really cheap car and drive it till it's gone or something like this, or till something breaks and then get the next junker. That does not really, it's not really working here. Unless you're missing your inspections, but yeah, there's going to be a whole lot of trouble, because I think you can even get your license pulled for that if you, I think you get some points in our point system, but the new iteration I'm not so familiar with compared to the old one. Like, we had a 15 point system where we could have maximum of 15 points, and now we have, like, I think an 8 point system, so it was a bit, made a bit less complicated, and now I don't understand it anymore. Now it's also quite my interest, and I haven't gotten a ticket where I would get a point in. Yeah, in 18 years, I think. Got some when I was like 18, 19, 20, in that range, but afterwards, never again. So, not really a concern of mine overall. Yeah, but that's the car story, so I hope it's back. Oh, that does not look good. Well, I hope it's back till. It has to be back till Friday, because then there's the teat operation. The kids are both coughing and have running noses, which is fantastic, because they can't go to kindergarten. And actually, it's the second to last week in kindergarten till summer vacation, and like the 3 weeks on the kindergarten, and then school is starting. So, for everything already prepared. I sealed it up because the kids already saw it. I did show it on my videos, in the danger the kids would maybe spot the stuff we got. Yeah, kind of dumb now, in which perspective, because yeah, of course they find the stuff way, way, way before. But yeah, so they're a bit more excited due to that. Yeah, so let's go back to work. Those are some of the conveniences of working at home, because usually I would have needed 2 days of vacation for pulling this off, or at least one day. But I think that shop also opens on Saturdays, so it's probably never ever again wasting vacation days on car repairs, I guess. I hope we won't have one in the next 2 years, so that's what I'm hoping for. said, the car should run for about 2 years now without any bigger problems. Then the next TÜV is due, and then we can decide if we get, if we do repair it once more, or if we get a new or used, good used old car again. And this year it was like, it was on the brink, right? Like 50 euros over my limit, which I had set for repairing, but due to misfortune and events, so I think we are still there, so hopefully it drives 2 more years, and then we'll see. At like 200,000 kilometers now. What was that?
So, I'm once more on the road. Oh, nice cows here. As you guys can see them. So, yeah, I'm getting rid of all the waste paper once more. Yeah. So, we had the tendency to collect it at home. Yeah, actually, our waste paper collection is free in Germany. But yeah, we have like a box at our container at our house. Yeah, it has gets emptied once a month, and usually it's quite full. So we often stored stuff down, and now with all the additional stuff, yeah, it was a nice placing for the cat and kids for a while. But now it has to go. Yeah, cars back from the shop, and there's some noise going on which I don't like. So maybe the brakes or something. Maybe that's just the driving, but not quite sure. So glad I'm not here with the kids, because the car is all full with waste paper. Yeah, which would probably not be good if we get into any, if we go up in flames or something, but that shouldn't be happening. So yeah, but like every time I invested serious money in this car, something bad has happened. So yeah, not really a big believer in such stuff, but yeah, there's a pattern there. It's probably like yeah, you feel it much more if you go invest 1,000 euros and then something breaks. It's much more noticeable than something breaking out of the blue, like the lock for the hood did break at some point, and our like the container for the power steering oil was leaking at one point, and like the power steering fluid was dripping all over the parts, and like the serpentine belt, and yeah, so it was making quite some noise, and we were losing quite some liquid there. So it was quite worrisome, but actually not that expensive. But yeah, the container for the fluid had broken, had cracked around its screw-on cap. So yeah, quite strange thing. And the shop was sure it was broken for a longer time, which could be, but that was not leaking. So it started leaking like after one driving maneuver, and then it was making all that sound because the liquid was going on the serpentine belt, which luckily could be cleaned. So no, this was quite cheap overall. Yeah. Well, I keep the costs for the car in control. I have an app called Car Expenses where I log my expenses for the car, and yeah, I'm driving around 20 cents per kilometer, I think, and this is yeah, nothing you can actually get on the market. So just because the car has so little value, but I already talked about this, so I said that the value depreciation is actually in all cars around, it's actually the biggest cost factor. So the full economy is, I think it's like repairs and full economy and full fuel come up to about the same for me. But if I had like less repairs but more loss of value comparatively, but yeah, I think it's for many people it's harder to calculate because they're like, yeah, you already paid for the car, so where's the loss of value? But it's the thing, if you pay, you can easily pay like prices up to the house price here, but you can easily get from a normal car in Germany, you pay about 30,000, new one, 20 to 30,000 euros, I guess, if it's a little bit more comfy. Small cars or very cheap ones go for about 16,000. I think the Dacia ones, they are like, they're going on the market with, yeah, we're building the cheapest car, and they are slightly below 10,000 euros, so they're quite cheap. My sister has one, but they have a bad reputation, so, like, yeah, I think they're built in Romania for, it's like two or three generation back, we know what they are building, actually, so it's like a technically inferior, low quality car, but you probably get what you're paying for, so it's like almost half the price of any other car you can get, so yeah, it's like a mixed bag, but yeah, there are very few cars where you can consider buying them new, my point of view. Because for me, the car is mostly something, yeah, it's like a tool. We use it, we go shopping, we do stuff with it, but I have a new dent on my door. Somebody bumped this door into my door. So, yeah, that happens. And, my work colleague, he said, since he started working at our company, but this car is never stationed, so it's not from there. But he said, that he had so much small damage on his car, it's really depreciating the value much more than it should usually do. But usually it's like, if you do that, it's like a real serious offense in Germany. Like, if you bump your door there, it's like, costs easily like 1,000 euros in fines if you get caught. But yeah, actually, nobody gets caught, and yeah, so very rarely happens. So if you drive off a mirror or something, there's always somebody seeing that. Actually, everybody has insurance in Germany, so it's usually not a big deal. But of course, your insurance rates go up. They actually don't go up for your points if you're driving bad, but they go up if you have an accident, or if the insurance has to regulate an accident. So, like many insurance offer you that you pay your own damage and then, or the damage on the other car, and then they don't raise your payments, and it's often much cheaper in the long term. And then for us with the truck accident there, it was like a little bit, I think the insurance could have fought, but the damage was not high enough there for that, and it was also too high for us to buy out. It was like 3,500 euros, like a broken lamp, and yeah, broken fender on the truck, and yeah, it was a reasonable price, so it was not about what I expected damage to be, but this was like, if you had like steered a little bit instead of braking, nobody would have got any damage. But yeah, so the main error was on my side, so the insurance didn't go and fought for me. So yeah, I think I also changed insurance company afterwards. That was that. Like, here's a paper factory, and they have like a big box where you can drop your paper on their parking ground. So that's what I'm attempting now. Hopefully, it's open. So it's, I'm in a bit of a problem there. As you call those trucks are bringing in stuff for the factory. Yeah. Yeah, but enough video for this week, I guess.
So we got a ladybug, monster ladybug there.
Little bear, how foggy it has become. It's not as bad here, but down our house there were some people popping up out of the fog, like, yeah. And yeah, visibility has been steadily above 75 to 100 meters, I guess, on the road. So. One interesting thing is that the automatic light turn on does not work on fog at all, because I guess it's overall much much brighter than usual because of all the reflection from the fog. So, there's something you have always said to be sure. I've missed the train again, of course. So we have to drive the car. Let's save the waiting time at the post here. Yeah, now visibility is up to about 150 meters, I guess. 150. But yeah, here it's getting thicker, I think. I really like fog in a way, that way, but they're not for jogging. It's clingy to everything, but in the car it's interesting because you have this feeling of driving into nothingness. At one time, especially in the winter when the road, the ground is white as well. Give it a really surreal effect. There on the road down, it's getting much lighter.
So we are taking another try at the dentist and see if we can get that broken teeth out there. And it's the road where my mother lives, and yeah, it's quite loud. I hope I can be heard. Can be overheard over the road here. Yeah. It's really, really loud here. It's like because of the. It's not. Actually, they're not driving so fast, but it's going up the mountain and this sunken road like thing here. Sunken in road really makes it much, much louder. Also, there are very many cars that might contribute as well. Other than that, it's actually a not so bad place overall. So like over here, if you go down there, you have like open fields and stuff, and like the cemetery, and like about half a kilometer that way, there's a forest starting there, so like 400-500 meters that way. So, yeah, we went to the dentist, and of course my son was not cooperative, and I was very angry with him, and we went to my mother's, and then she said, maybe we could try my dentist, and yeah, he's like a guy in a village with one assistant, and like it was Friday at around 16, 17, hours in the evening, and yeah, we called him and said, let's take a look. So yeah, a really relaxed, it sounded really relaxed on the phone, so we drove there with my mother, and he took a look and said, so like the other dentist was like, we have to go to a hospital, we have to put him under
pull the teeth, do that and that and that, and yeah, and you have to pay, and you have to do that, and it was really stressful for us. So we went to that dentist, and yeah, he opened the door, and he was in jogging shorts and a jogging t-shirt, and I first thought he was in his underwear, so I was really a little bit shocked, and yeah, down in a village, quite far off, near our famous airport, but yeah. So he took a look and he said, yeah, okay, science there is like there's a hole where the pus can go out. It's not quite good that the teeth is infected and you can't get the infection out there. But actually it's probably better to let it in for the time being, and if we would take it out, this would be better to do in the hospital, of course. So he agreed there, but he said, yeah. Basically, he was a dentist in the German Democratic Republic, and he said back there we would have just drilled in one more hole on the top and let it rot out. So basically, that was what he said. But yeah, he said there's not so much danger for the new teeth coming through, and probably better to just let it there and observe and yeah, do something if it's really necessary, but not at this point. So yeah, so we're trying that, and we're trying that. And my mother also said, oh yeah, of course, she already put like four kids and whom else through the dentist. Yeah, she can also bring our kids, because yeah, like the plan with going to the hospital and stuff, this would have been already has been quite stressful with all the other dentists. So like, yeah, like driving around and yeah, getting the appointments. It was not so bad because due to me working at home at the part time, but it was quite stressful for everybody involved. So yeah, maybe that's his very relaxed approach is maybe what we need. Not quite sure, but yeah, I'll keep you up to date if anything changes. And the car makes a horrible noise if I put it in reverse, so I have to call the shop again tomorrow. And they probably have to take a look. Well, yeah, I hope you enjoyed the week.